Hello students, my name is Gandharva Hemant Pednekar, Research Associate, School of Development Studies, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. I will be discussing about the module on Measurement of Housing Conditions Emerging from the Censuses 2001 to 2011. In this module, we will learn about the quality indicators of housing, household amenities, and household assets. Census. In 2011, census in India was conducted in two phases. The first phase is the house listing, which began on 1st April 2010 and involved collection of data about all the buildings and census houses. Information for the National Population Register was also collected in first phase. The second phase is the population enumeration phase, which was conducted from 9th to 28th February 2011 all over the country. The house listing schedule includes questions on building number, census house number, predominant material of the floor, wall and roof of census house, a certain use of actual house, condition of the census house, household number, total number of persons in the household, name of the head of the household, sex of the head of the household, caste status like SC or ST or others, ownership status of the house, number of dwelling rooms, number of married couples in the household, main source of drinking water, availability of drinking water source, main source of lighting, latrine within the premises, type of latrine facility, wastewater outlet connection, bathing facility within the premises, availability of kitchen, fuel used for cooking, radio or transistor, television, computer or laptop, telephone or mobile phone, bicycle, scooter, motorcycle or moped, car, jeep or van, and available banking services. The difference between 2001 and 2011 house listing schedules were mainly as follows. The question number 19, married couples having independent room for sleeping, was present in 2001 schedule and was removed from 2011 schedule. An additional question on type of latrine and availability of computer or laptop was also added in 2011. The question on telephone was modified with the inclusion of mobile phone. Based on the data from house listing data of 2001 and 2011, the following changes between the two were observed. House quantity. The number of census houses has increased from 25 crore to 33 crore. Out of this 33 crore, which accounts for 33% in total, rural households are 24% and urban households are 54%. The number of residential and partly residential houses has increased from 19 crores to 25 crores. Of this 25 crores, which accounts for total of 31% of the total households, rural households are 23% and urban households are 51%. Though figures of houseless population and infirm structures would be required for making accurate estimation of housing shortage, the trend seems to be a reducing one. If we see the table number 1, that is number of census houses India 2001 and 2011, which shows the figures in crores, we can see that in census house, the categories are number of census houses, occupied census houses, used as residence come other use, and housing stock. If we see the comparison between 2001 and 2011 data, the number of census houses has gone up from 24.9 crores to 33.1 crore, that is a variation of 32.8%, while the occupied census houses shows a variation of 31.3%. Among these, the used as residence show a variation of 31.7%, while used as residence come other use show a variation of 8.8%. Overall, the housing stock shows a variation of 30.7%. Table number 2, number of households and the housing stock 2001-2011. Between the census year 2001 and 2011, the number of households as described earlier have significantly increased. The number of households in crores in 2001 was 19.2, while in 2011 it is 24.7. While housing stock has gone from 18.7 to 24.5. If we see, the gap between number of households and housing stock was 0.5 in 2001, while in 2011 it has reduced to 0.2. The gap in housing stock can also be observed in the graphs shown herewith. It brings out the gap in number of households and housing stock, and it shows us that the gap is reducing. Housing quality. Many variables define the quality of housing. Houses can be found by analyzing the data on material for roof, floor and wall. Table 3, households by material of roof for rural and urban India 2001 and 2011. Among the various materials listed for roof, the main are grass, thatch, bamboo, wood or mud combined as one category, then tiles, handmade tiles, machine made tiles, GI, metal, asbestos sheets, concrete and others. If we see the total differentiation between 2001 and 2011 census data, it can be observed that grass, thatch, bamboo, wood and mud roofs have reduced from 21.9% to 15.0%, while there is also an increase in tiles, that is from 32.6% to 23.8%. Significant increase is seen in case of households having concrete roof, from 19.8% to 29.0%. If we see the percent change as per rural or urban areas, in case of rural household, the largest negative change has been in the category of tiles, that is -8.9%, while the increase has been mostly in concrete, that is 7.3%. In case of urban household, a similar trend can be seen, with the reduction being mainly in tiles, that is a percent change of -6.5%, and the increase in concrete, which is a positive change of 9.5%. If we see the graphical representations of households by materials of roof in India 2001 to 2011 in percentages, this differentiation is largely visible across both the years. Data of Table 3, when we see overall, shows a decline in percentage of households using grass, thatch, bamboo, wood, mud, tiles as material of roof from 2001 to 2011. Data of Table 3 also shows an increase in percentage of households using GI, metal, asbestos sheets and concrete as material of roof from 2001 to 2011. The next table, table number 4, is about households by material of walls for rural and urban India 2001 and 2011. The materials are grass, thatch, bamboo, mud, unburned bricks, stone, packed with mortar, not packed with mortar, burned bricks and other. When we see the data in totality between 2001 and 2011, it is observed that the houses having walls of mud and unburned bricks has reduced from 32.2% to 23.7%, whereas there is an increase in households having stone walls from 99.4% to 14.2%. The houses having burned brick as wall material has also shown increase from 43.7% to 47.5%. Among the rural areas, the households showed variation mainly in mud or unburned bricks, where there is a negative 9.2% change and the increase in burned bricks is from 5.8%. In case of urban areas, the change is more prominent in case of stone, that is in 2001 it was 6.7%, in 2011 it has increased to 15%. 8.2%, that is a change of positive 8.3%. Overall, the data from Table 4 shows that the quality of material used for walls has improved from 2001 to 2011 for total rural and urban areas. The next table, table number 5, households by material used for floor for rural and urban households 2001 and 2011. The various materials categorized under this are mud, stone, cement, mosaic or floor tiles and others. In totality, we can see that in case of 2001, mud households were 57.1, while the households were 46.5% who had mud as the flooring. In case of cement, the increase is from 26.5% in 2001 to 31.1% in 2011. Similarly, in case of mosaic or floor tiles, the increase is from 7.3% in 2001 to 10.8% in 2011. In case of rural household, significant change of negative 9.7% can be observed in case of mud, while a positive change of 6.2% can be observed for cement as material used for floor. In case of urban household, a similar trend is seen, but there is also an increase in mosaic and floor tiles by 5.4%. Overall, the data from Table 5 shows that the percentage of mud houses has declined from 2001 to 2011, indicating that the quality of housing material used for roof, wall and floors is improving. Now we'll look at housing quality. The second characteristic, number of rooms. Table number 6, distribution of households by number of rooms 2001 and 2011. Under this, the various categories are no exclusive room, one room, two room, two rooms, three rooms, four rooms, five rooms, and six rooms and above. In case of 2001, when we see the total data, we can see that 3.1% households had no exclusive room, while in case 2011, it has increased to 3.9%. The households having other one room, two room, three room, four room, or five room doesn't show significant change, but households having six rooms and above were 3.7% in 2001, which has reduced to 2.8% in 2011. Overall, the data of Table 6 shows that there is not much of change in percentage distribution of number of rooms between 2001 and 2011. Table 7, distribution of households by household size 2001 and 2011 in percentage. The household size, if we see in totality between 2001 to 2011, we can observe that the households having 3 member has increased from 11.1% to 13.6%, while the households having 6 to 8 members have reduced from 28.1% to 24.9%. Also, there is an increase in number of households having 4 members, 19.0% in 2001 to 22.7% in 2011. The decrease is also observed in households having more than 9 members, from 11.3% in 2001 to 6.6% in 2011. In case of the overall category, we can see that the data of Table 7 shows that there is an increase in the number of households with 1 to 4 members and decline in 5 and above members. Table number 8, number of married couples in a household 2001 and 2011. The number of married couples are categorized as none, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and above. In total, we can see that only in case of number of married couples 2 in an household, there is a change from 13.5% in 2001 to 14.1% in 2011, while there is a reduction in households having 3 married couples from 3.6 to 3.2. Overall data of table 8 shows that there is a marginal decrease in percentage of households with 3 or more married couples. Table 9, distribution of households by tenure status, 2001 and 2011. In case of the status, it has been divided into owned, rented and others. In case of owned, we can see that in 2001, 86.7% of households were owned, while in 2011, the percentage is 86.6%. In case of rented household, the total was 10.5% in 2001 and 11.1% in 2011. Much of the owned households are very large in rural areas as compared to urban areas where the rented households are more, like 28.5% in 2001 to 27.5% in 2011. Housing quality, third indicator, household amenities, drinking water. Table 10, drinking water sources in India, 2011. The categories are tap from treated sources, from untreated sources, well from covered well and from uncovered well, hand pump, tube well or bore well, and all other. The percentages show that tap as a source of water is the highest with 43.5%, followed by hand pump 33.5%. Overall, we can see the data of table 10 shows that 87% of the households are using tap, tube well, hand pump and covered well as source of drinking water. The data also shows that 32% households using tap water from treated sources. In case of table 11, distribution of households by major sources of drinking water between 2001 to 2011, we can see that tap as a water source in totality in 2001, the percentage was 36.7%, whereas in 2011, the percentage has increased to 43.5%. In case of rural areas, the percentage has increased from 24.3% in 2001 to 30.8% in 2011. The urban-rural differentiation is 44.4% in 2001, while in 2011 it is 39.8%. Overall, data of Table 11 shows that there has been an increase in the availability of water through tap and hand pump in 2011 in rural areas. The data also shows that there is considerable gap in rural and urban areas in the availability of water through tap and hand pump. Table 12, access to drinking water source, India 2001 and 2011. In this, the categories are within premises, near, that is within 500 meters in rural areas, or within 100 meters in urban areas, and away, that is 500 meters or beyond in rural areas, or 100 meters or beyond in urban areas. If we see the away category in total, in 2001 the percentage was 16.7, while in 2011 the percentage is 17.6. That means the rural urban differentiation is also shown as in 2001 negative 10.1%, in 2011 negative 14.1%. Overall, the data of table 12 shows that 47% of the households have source of water within the premises, that is rural 35% and urban 71%. The data also shows that 36% of households have to fetch water from a source located within 500 meter in rural areas or 100 meters in urban areas, and 18% still fetch drinking water from a source located more than 500 meters away in rural areas or 100 meters in urban areas. Now we'll discuss about the amenities, main source of lighting. Table 13 shows main source of lighting 2011 India. The categories are electricity, kerosene, solar energy, other oils, any other, and no lighting. The data of table 13 shows that 67% households use electricity and 31% of households use kerosene for lighting in 2011. Table 14, households having electricity as main source of lighting 2001 to 2011. In case of electricity, the change between 2001 to 2011 is 11.4% in total. In rural, it's 11.8% and in urban, it is 5.1%. Overall, the data of table 14 shows that in 2011, 67% households use electricity, rural 55%, urban 93%, which is an increase of 11 point over 2001 when rural was 12 points and urban is 5 points. Bathing facilities, table 15. Households having bathing facilities within the premises 2011. The categories are having bathing facility within premises which have facility of bathroom, enclosure without roof and does not have the facility. In total, we can see that 42% have bathroom, enclosure without roof 16.4% and 41.6% do not have the facility. Overall, the data of table 15 shows that in 2011, 58% households have bathing facility, that is rural 45% and urban 87%. Table 16, households having bathing facility within the premises. In comparison to 2001 and 2011, we can see that the percentage change in points is for total 22.3, for rural 22.2 and for urban 16.6. Overall, the data of table 16 shows an increase of 22 points over 2001 when rural was 22 points and urban was 17 points. In number of households having bathing facility within the premises in 2011, the data also shows that rural-urban difference reduced by 26 points from 48 points in 2001 to 22 points in 2011. Drainage connectivity, table 17. Households having drainage connectivity 2001 and 2011. The categories are closed drainage, open drainage and no drainage. The rural-urban differentiation is largely seen in this category. Overall, the data of table 17 reveals that 51% of households have drainage facility, that is rural 37% and urban 82%, with 18% households have closed drainage, that is rural 6% and urban 45%, and 33% households have open drainage, that is rural 31% and urban 37%. It could also be seen that 49% households have no drainage facility, that is in case of rural 63% and in case of urban 18%. The data also shows that there is a 5-point decline in households having no drainage, in case of rural 3-point and in case of rural urban 4-point. And the rural-urban difference in no drainage increased by 1 point from 44 point in 2001 to 45 point in 2011. Latrine within premises, table 18. Households having latrine facility 2001 and 2011. Households having latrine facility are categorized as those households who have latrine facility within premises and do not have latrine facility within premises. Overall, the data of table 18 reveals that 47% of households have a latrine facility. In case of rural, it's 31%, while in case of urban, it's 81%. And there is a 11-point decline in households having no latrine. In case of rural, 9 points, and in case of urban, 8 points. Table 19. Households having latrine facility within the premises, 2011. The categories are, have latrine facilities, A. Flush, pour, flush, connected to piped water system, septic tank and other system. Category B. Pit latrine, with slab, ventilated, without slab, open pit. C. Night soil, disposed into open drain. Or D. Service latrine, night soil removed by human, night soil serviced by animal. The data of table 19 reveals that 36% households have water closet, that is in rural 19%, while in urban 73%. The data also shows that 9% households have pit latrine. In case of rural, it's 11%, while in case of urban, it's 7%. While 1% households have other types of latrine, in rural 1% and in urban 2%. Kitchen, table 20, households having separate kitchen, 2011. The categories are availability of kitchen, 1, cooking inside house, A, has kitchen, B, does not have kitchen, 2, cooking outside house, has kitchen, B, does not have kitchen, and 3, no cooking. Overall, the data of table 20 shows that 61% households have kitchen facility, in case of rural 53% and in case of urban 79%. While 56% households have kitchen facility within premises, in case of rural 45%, in case of urban 78%. 6% households have kitchen facility outside premises. The percentages in rural are 7%, while in urban it is only 2%. Fuel used for cooking. Table 21, fuel used for cooking, 2011. Various fuels are used for cooking. The categories are 1. Firewood, 2. Crop residue, 3. Cow dung cake, 4. Coal, lignite or charcoal, 5. Kerosene, 6. LPG or PNG, 7. Electricity, 8. Biogas, 9. Any other, or 10. No cooking. Overall, the data of table 21 shows that 67% households use firewood or crop residue, cow dung cake or coal, etc. In case of rural, the percentage is 87%, while in case of urban, it's 26%. About 29% households use LPG or PNG or electricity or biogas. In case of rural, percentage is 12%, while in case of urban, it is 66%. And 3% households use kerosene. In case of rural, the percentage is 1%, while in case of urban, it's 8%. The data also shows an increase of 11 points in the use of LPG. In rural, 6 points and in urban, 17 points. Banking services, table 22. Households availing banking services, 2001 and 2011. The overall difference between the 2001 and 2011 in percentage is observed from 35.54% in 2001 to 58.70% in 2011. Table 22 shows that the number of households using banking services has almost doubled since 2001. The data also shows that the difference in rural and urban has reduced by 6 points from 2001. Household assets. 1. Radio or transistors. Households having radio or transistor in India in 2001 and 2011 have been graphically represented here. The data shows that there has been a decrease of 15 points, that is rural 14 points and urban 19 points, in percentage of households having a radio or transistor in 2011, with about 20% households having radio or transistor. In case of rural, 17%, in case of urban, 25%. Television. Table 24, households having television, 2001 and 2011. The data can be seen here represented graphically. The data in table 24 shows an increase of 16 points, rural 14 points, urban 12 points, in percentage of households having televisions in 2000, with about 47% households have television. In case of rural, it's 33%, while in case of urban, it's 77%. Computer or laptop. Table 25, household possessing assets like computer or laptop, 2011. The assets are categorized as computer, computer laptop with internet, and computer laptop without internet. Overall, the data in table 25 shows about 20% households in urban areas and 5% in rural areas possess the asset. The data also reveals that 9% households have computers or laptops. In case of rural, it's 5%, while in case of urban, it's 19%, with 3% households having internet. In case of rural, 1%, in case of urban, 8%, and 6% households having no internet, in case of rural 4% and in case of urban 10%. Telephone. Table 26, household possessing assets, telephone, 2011. The data is represented graphically here. Overall, the data in Table 26 shows that 63% households have telephone. In case of rural, it's 54%, while in case of urban, it's 82% in 2011, which is an increase of 54 points. In rural, it's 51 points. In urban, it's 59 points over 2001. And 59% households have mobile telephones. In case of rural, 51%. In case of urban, 76%. Four-wheelers. Table 27. Households possessing assets, four-wheelers, car, jeep or van. The data is represented graphically here. The data shows that 5% households have four-wheelers, in rural 2%, in urban 10%, which is an increase of 2 points, rural 1 point and urban 4 point from 2001. Two-wheelers, that is scooter, moped or motorcycle. Table 28, households possessing asset, two-wheelers has been represented here. The data shows that 21% households have two-wheelers, in case of rural 14%, in case of urban 35%. Which is an increase of 9 points, in rural 8 points and in urban 11 points from 2001. Bicycle, table 29, household possessing assets, bicycle, 2011 census. The data has been represented graphically here and it shows that 45% households have bicycles, in rural 46%, in urban 42%, which is an increase of 1 point. In rural areas, 3 point and in urban area negative 4 point from 2001. Households possessing none of the specified assets is the last category. Table 30 shows households possessing none of the specified assets in India in 2011 census. The data in Table 30 shows that about 18% of the household possessing none of the specified assets in 2011, which is a decrease from 2001 by 17 point. The difference in rural and urban household that possess none of the specified assets also showed a decrease by about 5%. Thank you.